According to the Minister of Justice and Constitutional Affairs, citizens are suffering from human rights violations and many face difficulty in accessing justice. Mao lashed out at some government officials who take cases filed against them personally.
Can't we make complaining part of our culture? At least we in the courts of law, when a judge has dismissed your case, he says you have the right of appeal, and even adds it, right of appeal explained to the plaintiff. Even in criminal cases, somebody say, I've sentenced you to death, but you have a right of appeal. Can we make complaining part of our culture?
He raised the concern while officiating at the opening ceremony of the 5th Business and Human Rights Symposium, which was held in Kampala. Mao reiterated the commitment to amendment of the Judicature Act to increase the number of judges, both at the Court of Appeal and Supreme Court, so they can expeditiously handle the growing human rights violation cases.
Probably next week, going to table an amendment of the Judicature Act to increase the number of justices of the Court of Appeal from 15 to 56 to create very many appeal jurisdictions or circuits. We are not stopping there. So we are also increasing, under the same amendment of the Judicature Act, the number of justices of the Supreme Court from 11 to 21.
He emphasized that it will not be business as usual, as the Attorney General will also no longer give legal support to government officials who violate human rights.
Businesses, whether national or transnational, have to comply. There are those big-headed international companies that want to play by different rules. I want to tell you unequivocally, the law applies to you also. I know it sounds politically incorrect because some businesses have taken photos with the president of Uganda, so they think their rules are different from the rules of somebody who has not taken a photo with the president of Uganda.
The chairperson of the Uganda Human Rights Commission, Mariam Wagadia, asked the government for more funding to the commission. She pointed out some of the persistent human rights abuses at the business places, including child labor, compensation issues, and underpayment, among others.
Businesses have had a negative impact on the enjoyment of human rights. These include, but are not limited to, underpayment, child labor, compensation issues, and land conflicts, displacement of people, environmental pollution, and violation of cultural rights.
There is quite a lot of human rights violations that are taking place in the extractive sector in the Karamoja sub-region, notably child labor, where many children are now no longer in schools, but they are into the extractive sector.
Committed to the promotion and protection of human rights in all business operations across the country. To effectively execute our mandate, I take this opportunity to urge the government to adequately fund the commission. I call for continued cooperation and collaboration amongst all the agencies.
Story compiled by Jalet Namwaya for the news.